Workers at the Hyatt Regency Hotel in downtown Buffalo are now accusing hotel leaders of union busting. The group Buffalo Hyatt Workers United announcing today they have filed charges with the labor board against their employer. Today I spoke with workers and their attorney about their claims.
I think that they, especially then, they need to be held very accountable for how they've treated this whole process.
Workers from the Hyatt Regency Buffalo gathering Wednesday to announce they filed charges with the National Labor Relations Board for what the group calls a union busting campaign being waged by the hotel.
For me personally, it's been like really sort of shocking and a bit horrifying to see the ways that they've responded to our campaign so far.
Earlier this summer, the group says it started organizing a union under the name Buffalo Hyatt Workers United. Workers allege that since they presented that campaign to managers, they faced intimidation tactics and attacks on workers' rights.
They've threatened workers in all kinds of ways. Even just in the past month, they've fired, I think, 8 people now. From the departments that we sort of petitioned for an election.
Those claims filed this week in an unfair labor practice charge, citing 25 violations against hotel management and Ambridge Employee Service Corporation, which operates the Hyatt.
Those violations can be generally categorized into 2 categories. One is illegal coercive conduct and the other is illegal retaliation.
There are a couple of workers that were fired for reasons that honestly were not, there are policies that were not enforced before that have been enforced since the union had came out.
Workers say while the alleged violations came from upper management at the hotel, they ultimately believe the issue leads back to the owner of the Hyatt, Douglas Jamal.
I think Douglas knows what he's doing. Whether Ambridge hired these consultants, I think Douglas, you know, if he wanted to sign on to the fair election principles, you know, and give us a fair election here, I fully believe he has the power to do that.
Now, I reached out to Ambridge Hospitality that manages the Hyatt Regency, a spokesperson telling me in a statement, quote, every day we set out to create a safe, healthy, and positive work environment for our associates. Due to pending litigation, we are unable to comment any further. I also reached out to hotel management and Douglas Jamal, but did not hear back. The current group looking to unionize consists of roughly 45 front of house workers. I'm told a vote is pending the decision and direction of the election from the National Labor Relations Board.